G'day guys. So, not long ago, we were out looking for some nocturnal mammals, the colugo, slow loris. I'd gone off to drop some of our volunteers home, and I suddenly get a call saying, quick, come. We got a big snake. And after a little bit of a wrestle with some vines and some foliage, we finally managed to get this guy out into the open. This is a very pretty dog-tooth cat snake, Boiga cynodon, the second largest cat snake species in Malaysia. The only one bigger is the Boiga dendrophila, the mangrove cat snake. Gorgeous black and yellow striped snake. But this guy, pretty calm. The mangrove, the dendrophila that I've found, super aggressive. But this guy's super calm, which is really nice because they're mildly venomous. But not dangerous, but I would rather not get tagged for my first time by this guy. This is actually a great opportunity here. This is a classic cat snake position. They're mainly arboreal, spending most of their time up in the trees, and this is their little strike position. But this guy is not really looking to strike at the moment. I can tell because when they're sort of getting super stressed and when they're getting a bit defensive, they'll puff themselves right up, you know, just behind their head. They'll sort of suddenly become nice and big, really looking quite aggressive. And that's when you know they're looking like they're gonna strike. But they make these gorgeous little S shapes, you know, the classic sort of snake position. It's certainly one of my favorite positions to look at a snake in. I mean, you know, the muscles on these guys are just incredible. As we pull them out of the snake bag just here, you know, he's probably nearly, I'd say at least a 2 meter snake, and he's over half his body just straight up into the air. And that's some serious power. And then most of their diet consists of small birds, bird eggs, which is why they spend so much time in the trees at night. But they've been known also to take, you know, small lizards, small mammals, whatever else they can catch. Now, they're called the cat snake because of their eyes. They've got very pretty eyes, but the most important part is the vertical pupil. It looks just like a cat's, which helps them see at night. So that's how they get their name of the cat-eyed snake, which makes this one a bit interesting as it's the dog-toothed cat-eyed snake. But you know, that's a bit fun. It looks like he might have he's got a few scars, a couple of injuries here and there, in his scales. And a little something in here, a little growth somewhere back here. You know, he's maybe not had the easiest of lives, but otherwise, absolutely gorgeous specimen. We're gonna let him go back into one of his trees and get on with his night. Hopefully he can find some birds to feed on and keep himself nice and full for a few days. But, you know, I hope that getting a look at this, well, I was going to say little guy, but quite large guy, really, means that, you know, snakes, shows you that snakes, there's nothing to fear from snakes. You know, you back them into a corner, they'll get a bit defensive, they might strike. But if you don't, you know, you leave them alone, you don't mess with them, they're totally fine. And if you're calm with snakes, as I like to think that I am, they're going to be pretty calm too. And this guy's totally chill. But you know, keep an eye out for snakes, they're pretty special animals. Pretty unique. I'm a huge fan, in case you haven't noticed. And I hope that you guys can fall in love with something just like this guy, who's just gorgeous. Look at that tongue. Look at those muscles. Ah, what a beautiful snake. Whoop. Just get him away from my face. He's super calm. Anyway, we're going to let him go, get on with his night. Thanks for joining us, guys, and we'll see you next time. See you later, big guy.